Now we've come just across the path into a field that's been in a rotation of wheat, corn, pea, basically that type of rotation, which we called it an eco-fallow rotation at one time. But two years of high-residue crops out of three, we've just come across from where we had half and half, and you see a very distinct difference in the structure of the soils. They're much more granular, because once you start to leave the soil alone so you're not disrupting the aggregate stability and allowing crusts to form and things, then you do have to have a certain amount of organic matter to hold it together. Now this still has a little bit of platiness as a remnant. You see some areas down in there just still a little platy, but they're relatively soft, but that's only two-thirds. And like I said, we think we need to have at least 3/4 high-residue crops in the system. And the wheat in this rotation in tough years will yield twice as much as on the other side, and even sometimes in good years it yields substantially more than on the other side. And this is a golf cup cutter look at it. You don't get that same platiness that you had before, but there's still a bit of it in there because it doesn't have quite enough. This is a sorghum field if you're looking at it. We do sorghum one time through the rotation is sorghum and canola, and the next time it's corn and peas. So the last time, last year, this would have been canola or flax. So it's an oil seed. 1 year out of six, it's a pulse 1 year out of six, and it's wheat 2 years out of six.